I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Can you ask the big G, Robert, what does he think of Mayweather in a cage? In the UFC?
He don't know what
to do. No, 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 no. ¿Usted qué piensa si Mayweather pelea en la jaula? En la jaula.
Pedro, no, 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 ni quiero saber eso.
I don't want to know that shit, come on.
He's a boxer.
He's a boxer. He's a boxer.
But he's going to make $1 billion.
He is, and I know he is.
What is it?
Hey, nothing but respect for that, hey. Making $1 billion, I would too.
You like right. Floyd in a cage?
$1 billion.
I'm taking my chance with the $100 million.
They're going to offer a fight with McGregor, a rematch with McGregor, and a fight with Khabib. Mayweather's never going to take it.
Mayweather in a cage, he posted another video of Pita and he said 2018.
LA, don't ask me questions about Floyd Mayweather. He's retired, I'm going to fall.
Okay, Eric Morales against Mayweather, who would have won?
Morales would have killed him.
Mikey,
Mayweather.
Eric Morales against Floyd Mayweather. Who would have won?
Floyd.
Murder.
Why does he say Eric?
No, what bad. Mayweather would have done is he would have waited until Morales got old and then fought him and then beat him a decision. No.
But hey, I think you're right, Robert. Everybody could think it's a joke, but Mayweather will fight in the cage.
I think so.
Because Broner told me 2 weeks ago that Mayweather's going to do something. He didn't tell me what.
The cage.
Okay. And he's gonna make $1 billion.
Okay.
They're gonna offer him that deal. They're gonna offer him a fight with McGregor, a rematch with McGregor, and then a fight with Khabib.
What about Nate Diaz?
A fight with Khabib. He's never gonna take
it. Okay, Mikey, would you have a fight in the UFC?
Once they tell him, you're gonna get in there with Khabib.
What?
He's never gonna take off that.
After you retired.
But I gotta learn some ground game.
I think you could do it. You're an athlete.
You got some ground game.
But he says if you're tapping out, I'm gonna let you pass out. I'm not gonna fucking let you go. Fucked up.
I have a question, Pita. How come when you choke someone out in the UFC, they come back to life, but when you choke someone out in real life, they're dead?
No, it's because they don't wait till you choke them all the way out. They tap.
Or no,
but they fall asleep and then they stop right away and they're able to wake up right away.
But if they
probably have smelling salts, I don't know.
Robert, how come when you choke someone out in Jiu-Jitsu, they don't die? But if you choke someone out, they die.
I know, it's crazy, huh?
Right?
They wake up right away.
Yeah.
And I elsewhere, you kill them.
Yeah, you stop the air. Would you want to work Mike's corner when he fights Khabib?
Oh, we go together.
Mikey, UFC, can you fight 145?
Mikey fought Khabib, what?
If he fought Khabib, 145.
I would advise him not to fight Khabib.
Mikey, Pita would advise you not to fuck up Khabib. Hey, Mikey would fuck up Khabib. He would not.
Huh?
Hey, you would give Khabib his first O, Mikey. You put him to sleep.
Nah, that's another world.
They can come take him to the ring.
In boxing, what would happen if Mikey boxed him?
What, Mikey Box?
Okay, I have a hard question for you. What if Eric Morales fought Khabib? Who would you go for?
The man, in the ring, Morales, in the cage, Khabib. You're an idiot. I have a hard question for you. Who would win? In a street fight? In a street fight?
Khabib. Why not? Eric's one of the homie from TJ.
He's from Tijuana, gangster. It'll go.
Well, he might have 100 gangsters popping up from everywhere. So check out what Mikey eats after a long, 10 rounds, 12 rounds today?
10 rounds.
And all wheat bread, honey, and bananas, and a shake.
Perfect.
And this is just sustaining you until dinner. It's not instead of dinner.
Then when I get home, I'll shower, and then I get an hour, I'll have dinner.
How important are these snacks in between meals?
Your metabolism going, so it really helps. But a lot of like old thinking, or for us, like before, we like cut the food, cut the
starve
water.
Starve yourself.
That's not the way to do it. We've learned that it's better to eat smaller portions throughout the day. Your metabolism going, you're burning fat, you're burning calories. You work hard, you eat well.
Mikey, how much have you become an expert in physical fitness just being a boxing champion?
You learn from the guys like working with Daryl Hudson, with Alex Ariza. You pick up on things from them. we've had other guys working, and so you learn little things here and there. You read, you listen to other people that do fishing, dive fishing, that kind of stuff. You pick out a lot of things. You learn a lot.
How important is it to drink water?
I didn't know this before. Yeah. I didn't even do this when I fought Salido. I didn't even know that. I didn't know none of this. You know, so
when you fought Juanma, if you knew all this, no problem. And now Pita's picking up a lot of it.
What?
How did the diet, the drinking water?
Oh my God. I like Rafa's hair style now. Rafa has hair, not bald.
No, you know who he looks like? What's his name? Vince Vaughn.
Vince Vaughn.
Yeah, Wedding Crashers. Little
old man hair. That's what's fucking gangster.
What? He's gay?
No, he's fucking gangster.
Oh, gangster, yeah. No, but same haircut, right? He's a great actor. I liked him in Dodgeball.
Dodgeball.
And Wedding
old school,
Crashers.
Old school.
Wedding Crashers.
Wedding Crashers.
No, Rafa looks like a different person. He asked me if he's younger this way.
Hold on.
Hey, what did they like better in the library? Will you have hair or no hair?
I think when you have hair.
Why? They think you have money, huh?
Nah, it's something to run their hair through. Their fingers through.
Do you have a library card?
Yep. Just renewed it this camp.
You know, Floyd owns a library.
I know.
Would you
call it a fucking crack house?
Who did?
What does that mean?
Connor did. The press got everything.
Wheat, goat, peanut butter, and banana honey.
Hey, why is Floyd taking the spotlight for all this fame? Everybody's talking about him in the UFC, and they just announced Canelo and Triple G.
You think that has to do with something? You think that has one of
the strategically. Everything he does is strategically done.
So he may fight. You're saying his UFC fight will be Cinco de Mayo? Do you think Floyd will get in a cage on Cinco de Mayo?
He could.
Something that could really happen is Mike against Max Holloway. So Mike,
I don't think he's been training like Robert thinks, because we would have already heard rumors about him actually training. People around him would have known and would have said something. Yeah,
pictures, videos.
Well, he might start to pick it up now, maybe. But it will still take him another year or two before he gets the ring.
It takes time.
That's too old.
But I did hear this for a long time, that he wants to open up Mayweather MMA, like Mayweather Promotions and MMA. That I did hear. So do you think this could be that he's doing his own MMA promotion?
Well, that's gonna be a difficult competition with the UFC.
Yeah? But maybe it's a lucrative business. Maybe you can make money in it.
Maybe he partners up with them.
Could be. Or he teams up with them, that's true. And then they team up with his boxing.
Maybe I'll lose 60 pounds and turn pro.
In what sport?
Boxing, bro, come on.
I don't know, maybe MMA. Have you ever taken karate?
What?
Have you ever taken karate?
Yeah, I actually did karate. I'm actually a blue belt.
A blue belt?
I'm not like an
awesome. He has skills?
That's after the white belt.
No.
White is yellow, then
it's orange, then it's green, then it's blue, or blue.
No, they had blue after the yellow.
But unfortunately, too many karate schools give away belts to keep the students. Because there are all these black belts that suck, they get their ass kicked. Back in the day, a black belt was a black belt. I knew this student of Bruce Lee would sell diplomas like you're a black belt Bruce Lee style.
Really?
So all the others would get mad at him, but he had to live.
It's a hustle, why not?
There's one boxing gym that gives out trunks.
One of these.
Good work, right?
Hey, what do you think? Agus, come here. Mikey, Agus Kavalauskas. Who do you want to see him fight at 147 after he takes care of business March 16 in Reno?
You take on Manny Pacquiao.
That would be a good one. You think you can put Manny to sleep?
He'll knock him out.
You will knock out Pacquiao?
I think. He'll knock him out.
Agus, do you knock out Pacquiao?
Hope so.
Who else? What is that?
So Pacquiao's gonna fight?
Yeah, he's fighting Mike Alvarado.
Is he?
That's what I heard. It may be wrong, but yeah, I heard that.
I was asking Mike Alvarado already like a couple fights ago.
But what happened?
He didn't take it. He don't want him. It's dangerous.
He wants Pacquiao instead of him?
That's the right way to do it.
Maybe more money.
No, I know Lomachenko wanted Pacquiao.
No,
he wanted, but I don't think the people around him wanted that fight for him.
I'm saying this.
But,
well, maybe. Oh, yeah.
No, this is what happened.
Turn up the volume and just sit back.
You rockin' with the best, Elie Seckbach, the wave of the future, we don't lose. Tell me what you watching, EsNews. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind, competition, he abusing.